I was, you know, pretty much peppered from head to toe with tumors, and that was a lot.
In 2021, Todd Wells got the news that he had stage 4 metastatic melanoma.
I'm kind of thinking it's probably not good. My dad died of lung cancer, so that went through my head.
Melanoma is a cancer of what's called melanocytes, or basically kind of a skin pigmentation cell. And it's unique in that it's particularly aggressive oftentimes. It'll kind of spread to really any part of the body.
I was going downhill really bad. I mean, gosh, the cancer was in my hip bone, my leg. I mean, all over the place, and it was hard walking. And I mean, it was even hard sleeping, just laying down. We got started on chemo pills, and gosh, that was within a week, I was feeling a little bit different, better. When I was on the chemo pills at the get-go, I had gotten an MRI, and there were like 3 spots up there.
Those 3 spots were 3 brain tumors. That's when Wells was introduced to Gamma Knife.
Gamma Knife is a really great addition where our colleagues in the radiation oncology area can use targeted radiation to kind of pinpoint spots of spread, particularly inside the brain. What's used is a special mask or like a special kind of halo that kind of goes around the head to keep it really still. We can basically kind of provide this kind of very targeted kind of high dose radiation just to the spots that are involved with cancer in the brain.
So this can just take little parts, little less than a millimeter spots, and they can hit it and zap it and be done.
Wells eventually started immunotherapy.
The responses with immunotherapy can be quite durable or kind of last a long time because we're really just allowing the body's own immune system to really take over and give it a little bit more leeway to recognize the cancer cells.
But after another MRI, more tumors were discovered and Gamma Knife was used again.
Dr. Murphy did that procedure and got all 12 of those small spots, took care of that. Right now I'm on maintenance, just doing the immunotherapy still once a month and just keeping my immune system revved up to keep the tumor cells at bay.
He's really doing amazing. You know, it's always great to be able to look at the PET scans and everything and the labs and hear that he's doing well, but I think really kind of the most important thing that he's able to continue to live life, spend time with his kids, spend time with his friends and his job and his wife.
I'm just so thankful to be here. So many people have been so supportive. Just thank God every day.